Hello students, my name is Amit Kumar. Last time we had read the empirical formula and molecular formula. Now we are going to the new topic. The topic is law of chemical combination. All chemical reaction takes place according to the certain law called law of chemical combination. First is law of conservation of mass. Second, law of definite proportion. Third is law of multiple proportion. Fourth is law of reciprocal proportion. And fifth is law of combining volume. First, law of conservation of mass. According to this law, mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. Hence, total mass of the reactant must be equal to the total mass of the product. For example, on heating calcium carbonate, to give calcium oxide and carbon dioxide, the total mass of the reactant is equal to 40 is the atomic mass of calcium plus 12 is the atomic mass of carbon plus 16 into 3, that is atomic mass of one oxygen atom is 16 into 3 because there are 3 oxygen atoms in calcium carbonate is equal to 100 gram, means the total mass of the reactant is equal to 100 gram. And in the product side, the total mass of the product is equal to 40, that is the atomic mass of calcium, plus 16 atomic mass of oxygen, plus 12, that is the atomic mass of carbon, plus 16 into 2, that is atomic mass of one oxygen atom is 16 into 2 because there are 2 oxygen atoms in carbon dioxide is equal to 100 gram. It means that the total mass of the product is equal to 100 gram. This reaction follow the law of conservation of mass because the total mass of the reactant is equal to the total mass of the product. Second, law of definite proportion. According to this law, mass ratio of the element in a given chemical compound always remains same, and it does not depend on the method of preparation from which it has been obtained. For example,
there are 3 methods to the formation of carbon dioxide. In the first method, when carbon is burned in the presence of oxygen to give carbon dioxide. Here, the mass ratio of carbon and oxygen is 12:32. And the simple mass ratio of carbon and oxygen is 3:8. Here, 12 is the atomic mass of carbon and 32 the atomic mass of 2 oxygen atom. In the second method, on heating calcium carbonate to give calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Here, the mass ratio of carbon and oxygen is 12:32. And the simple mass ratio of the carbon and oxygen is 3:8. In the third method, on heating sodium bicarbonate to gives sodium carbonate, water and carbon dioxide. Here the mass ratio of carbon and oxygen is 12:32 and the simple mass ratio of carbon and oxygen is 3:8. Hence, in all case, carbon dioxide is present in same ratio, that is 3:8. So, this follow the law of definite proportion, because mass ratio of the element in a given chemical compound, that is carbon dioxide, always remains same, and it does not depend on the method of preparation from which it has been obtained. Third, law of multiple proportion. According to this law, if two different elements combine to form more than one compound, in which different mass of one element always combined with fixed mass of another element bear a simple ratio to one another, and which is in the form of multiples. For examples, according to this law, if two different elements, that is hydrogen and oxygen, combine to form more than one compound, that is water H2O and hydrogen peroxide H2O2. Here, when 2 gram of hydrogen react with 16 gram of oxygen to form H2O, and when 2 gram of hydrogen react with 32 gram of oxygen to form H2O2, in which different mass of one element, that is oxygen 16 gram and 32 gram, always combined with fixed mass of other element, that is hydrogen 2 gram and 2 gram, bear a simple ratio to one another. Simple ratio is 16/32 is equal to 1/2 is the simple ratio. This follow the law of multiple proportion. Fourth is law of reciprocal proportion. When two different elements combined with the same mass of third element, the ratio of the masses in which they do so must be same or multiple of the mass ratio in which they combine with each other. For example, when two different elements, that is carbon and hydrogen, combined with the same mass of a third element, that is oxygen. Here, when carbon combined with oxygen to form carbon dioxide, and the mass ratio of carbon and oxygen in carbon dioxide is 12:32, and the simple mass ratio of carbon and oxygen in carbon dioxide is 3:8. And when hydrogen combined with oxygen to form water H2O, and the mass ratio of hydrogen and oxygen in water is 2:16, and the simple mass ratio of hydrogen and oxygen in water is 1:8. According to the law of reciprocal proportion, if carbon and hydrogen combine with each other, then their mass ratio should be 3:1. That is, the mass ratio of carbon and hydrogen should be 3:1 or multiple of mass ratio in which they combine with each other. Let's see. When carbon combined with hydrogen to form methane, that is CH4, the mass ratio of carbon and hydrogen in CH4 is 12:4. The simple mass ratio of carbon and hydrogen is 3:1, which is same as we predicted. So this follows the law of reciprocal proportion. In carbon dioxide, the mass ratio of carbon and oxygen is 3:8, but in H2O, the mass ratio of hydrogen and oxygen is 1:8, in which fixed mass of oxygen combined with different mass of carbon and hydrogen, which follow the law of reciprocal proportion. Fifth is law of combining volume. When gases react together, they always do so in volumes which bears a simple ratio to one another and to volumes of the product. If these are also gases, provide all measurements of volume are done under similar conditions of temperature and pressure. For example, when 1 mole of hydrogen gas react with 1 mole of chlorine gas to give 2 mole of HCl gas, we can say that when 1 liter of hydrogen gas react with 1 liter of chlorine gas to give 2 liter of HCl gas, we can say that when 1 volume of hydrogen gas react with 1 volume of chlorine gas to give 2 volume of HCl gas. In the second example, when 1 mole of methane gas react with 2 mole of oxygen gas to give 1 mole of carbon dioxide gas and 2 mole of water liquid, we can say that when 1 volume of methane gas react with 2 volume of oxygen gas to give 1 volume of carbon dioxide gas, we cannot consider the water because water is liquid in state. According to the law of combining volume, if we use 2 liter of methane gas, then we need 4 liter of oxygen gas. Then it gives 2 liter of carbon dioxide gas.